Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We were expecting a Starlink launch earlier today, but that mission was postponed. However, there is a launch coming up soon. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of SES-22 is expected to lift off on Wednesday 29th at 9:04 PM UTC or 5:04 PM EDT. We've been hoping for the NASA Psyche satellite to launch on a Falcon Heavy this year, but NASA has released some unfortunate news. This article says NASA announced Friday the Psyche asteroid mission, the agency's first mission designed to study a metal-rich asteroid, will not make its planned 2022 launch attempt. Due to the late delivery of the spacecraft's flight software and testing equipment, NASA does not have sufficient time to complete the testing needed ahead of its remaining launch period this year, which ends on October 11th. There was a tweet posted about this. It says, NASA's Lori Glaze in a media telecon starting now confirms the Psyche asteroid mission is standing down from the 2022 launch window after running into software testing issues. Teams are evaluating launch opportunities in 2023 and 2024. Jared Isaacman posted some cool pictures on Twitter of the Polaris Dawn crew in their first week of training. Heading to Boca Chica, the orbital tank farm and Mechazilla Tower were seen venting recently. Work is continuing on the Star Factory production building at the production site. The crane in the production yard was disassembled and has started moving away from Starbase. There was a picture posted of an orbital launch mount segment being transported somewhere. It says SpaceX is either way behind on assembling the second Starship orbital launch mount, or this is for orbital launch mount number 3. Appears to be headed towards Pascagoula, which is the current home of Phobos and Deimos. There was a picture posted on Twitter of the launch tower SpaceX are building at the Cape for Starship. It says the Starship pad at LC-39A now has 2 of 9 sections stacked and is what you see attached to the crane. This is the view from 12 miles away through the haze. It's going to be impressive. Michael Baylor posted a tweet of a Raptor test that ended in a rapid unscheduled disassembly. He said, Raptor Rudd on the tripod stand in McGregor. First Rudd in a while. Remember that this is development testing, so not unexpected. He also posted another tweet saying, and SpaceX just fired a Raptor on another stand just minutes later. Pretty good indication that the Rudd was no biggie. Likely pushing the limits on purpose. Work continues on Starship 24 inside the high bay. With the work to get Starship 25 ready, SpaceX have installed the PEZ dispenser in the nose cone barrel section. Kevin Randolph posted this tweet with pictures of the mechanism being lowered into the ring stack. He said, Starlink payload adapter, aka PEZ dispenser, fitted into Ship 25 payload bay. Here's some footage of it actually being lowered in. The B7.1 test tank continues to be prepared for crush testing at the launch site. On Thursday, SpaceX rolled out the Booster 7 prototype to the launch site. SpaceX posted some awesome pictures of the Super Heavy Booster 7 prototype rolling out to the launch site. They said Super Heavy Booster 7 with 33 Raptor engines installed was transported to the orbital launch pad at Starbase. Later on, the chopstick catching arms were raised and B7 moved inside. Then, for the first time ever, we saw a booster lifted onto the orbital launch mount using the chopsticks. The BQD was then hooked up to Booster 7. There's some very exciting news regarding the Super Heavy Booster 7 prototype. This tweet was posted saying, hot off the presses, MSIB just released for possible static fire testing during 27th to 30th of June 2022, testing window from 10 AM to 10 PM. Finally for this video, we'll take a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website. With Booster 7 now rolled out to the orbital launch pad with 33 Raptor 2 engines installed, we can hopefully expect some static fire testing soon. As per the last tweet, there are possible closures scheduled for this coming week with tomorrow, Monday 27th, Tuesday 28th and Wednesday 29th. For this video, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content in this video. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.